Hey, guess what? It's Code It With AI, episode 5. I'm Carl Franklin from AppVNX. That's my friend Jeff Fritz from Microsoft. Hey, Jeff, what's shaking?
Hey, it has been a fantastic weekend. I had a great time this weekend, but I understand you had an even better time traveling this weekend.
I'm having a good time. I'm actually on a cruise ship somewhere along the East Coast. It's called Chefs Making Waves. And it's all the a handful of chefs from the Food Network that you probably know: Alton Brown, Alex Gornishelli, Gabe Bertaccini. Let's see, who else? Rocco DiSpirito. If you don't watch the Food Network, you have no idea who these people are. Andrew Zimmern.
Oh yeah,
is
yeah.
Here.
Mm-hmm.
And I got to Mark Murphy. I got to hang out with these people, and I say hang out. I saw them in the hallway and snapped a selfie. But I did get to ask a few questions here and there, so it's been fun. And you know, the food is great, and the camaraderie is great too. So
awesome.
Anyway, that's not what you're here for. We're here to show you how to turn a paragraph of text into a schedule. You know what I'm talking about? Like Google Calendar, where you have recurring appointments and appointments that happen on a certain time. And the story is, this came from a real world requirement. Well, it was not really a requirement. It was a feature I suggested to one of my customers. They have a complicated database table schema that represents working schedules for employees in this particular application. And they can be very, very complicated, like certain holidays the employee has off, like their lunch hours are expressed in their schedule, whether they work, you know, they have days off that are, you know, family days or whatever, vacations. Sure. So it's complicated. And the database structure is also very complicated. And what I'm talking to the customer, what ends up happening is, because their users really can't navigate the UI to appropriately set the data of the schedule, they end up sending a paragraph of text to my customer. And then the guys in the data center or whatever just add it in manually. And it's a very time consuming thing. So I thought, wouldn't it be great? Yeah, I thought, wouldn't it be great if we could get an AI to turn that paragraph into real data? Now, never mind the shape of the data shape of my customer, but what I did think of was the DevExpress Scheduler control, Blazor control.
Sure.
And this control is so awesome. Every time I talk to people about Blazor, I bring up their demo, and it works just like a Google Calendar. Like you can add appointments and drag them, drop them, and move them around and stretch them. And it's all web-based. It's great.
Yeah.
So that's what we set out to do this week. And it took a little bit longer. Sorry we're late, but we think we find, and Jeff, you deserve the credit for wrapping this whole thing up. So take it away. Well, tell us what we're looking at.
Yeah. All right. So over here in the code, and you can find the code, check out the link just below in the description so you can check out some of this code and give it a try on your own. Now, last time we tried working with the GitHub Copilot free models, and Carl and I tried working with those models, and they work great for this, but they take a little bit of time to return because they're free models. So I decided to set up a GPT-4o model that we're going to use for this one, so that we can click through and use that.
Okay, this is not a free model.
This is not a free model. I stood this up on Azure OpenAI. So you go out there, you go into an API service, and you can choose a model, register it, and set it up so that you can interact with it using your own API endpoint, your own password, your own token to interact with it.
Wow. Cool.
So I set up, just like we did last time, I set up a chat client that's going to reach out and interact with those services using a token I've got hiding here in user secrets, and my API endpoint, once again, sitting in user secrets. And we're going to connect with Azure OpenAI client, just like we saw last time.
Nice.
So, and we're going to put together on our homepage our DevExpress scheduler. Now, You can pause and look at how the scheduler is formatted here. That's not really what we're driving at, what we're trying to accomplish and teach you as part of this example. What we did do was we added a text box up at the top. Let me show you what the page looks like.
Okay. And while you're doing that, we should say that we started with the DevExpress Scheduler demo that's on the website. So you can go ahead and look at that on their website, and we'll provide a link to that. And you can even download the code and run it yourself. And Bob's your uncle.
Yep.
All right. So just tell us what we're looking at here.
So we placed this text box above, and I added a button translate schedule and a clear button so we can clear out the schedule so we can work on it. And
great.
And your idea, your scenario here, Carl, is perfect because the non-technical folks are going to describe their schedule as something like, right, I have a call with Carl at 3:30 p.m. today, and every day this week, I have a dinner scheduled with Becky. And we want to turn that into
5 p.m. or something.
Oh, yeah, good point. At 5 p.m.
Yep.
There we go. So we want to turn that into a schedule entry and then a recurring schedule that's going to occur for the rest of the week.
Yeah.
And we wired up a button that would hit the language model and present that. And when we try this out, there it is. It created, there's my call with Carl. There's my dinner with Becky. And if I open up and show the week, you see we get the recurrence pattern of that dinner. And it just assumed 2 hours for dinner.
Yeah, so that's pretty cool, Jeff.
So that's a good... Right. That's a good start. That's a good proof of concept that leads towards what you're talking about. But we had to build a pretty big prompt to go through this. And I created a little translator component that does this. Let's go dig under the covers and take a look at that one.
All right.
So when I click the button on the schedule page, it calls this method translate schedule and checks to make sure we have text. But then it calls into my translator and says, get the schedule from the text that was passed in.
Okay, so you have an enumerable of appointment, and are those the same? Is that the same appointment class that the DevX
not quite
demo uses?
So it's very similar. And what's great about the DevX components is you can use your own shape of appointment classes, set it up how you would like. And you can define some mappings that go from their standard types to your types so that you specify how the values from your class get loaded in. So I wrapped up that mapping and placed it here in this static property. So my translator is going to take in that text, and we're going to set up a really big system prompt here. Now, you can pause and read the prompt a little bit closer if you'd like to. Of course, I encourage you to download the code just below. But you can see here, I'm telling it right away, you're an expert at converting unstructured schedule descriptions into structured appointment data. And here I specify, this is the structure of my appointment types that I want you to create. Like I said, you can read through this. Wow. Some of these values are particular to how DevExpress's component formats and places content on screen. So see here,
this is so cool.
There's some unique things that we did to make the recurrence patterns work, because there's recurrence patterns that happen where we say, this is a daily appointment, right? I'm having dinner every day of the week with Becky. I can also say, hey, I've got a weekly call with Carl and Richard, and it would appear, and that's a different recurrence pattern. So all kinds of information here. Once again, I encourage you to check that out. Read it on your own. But the important things that you can do here, and where I really want you to pick up, is I'm reaching into that language model chat client, and I'm just saying get response. And notice I have a generic here, right? I'm using the Microsoft Extensions AI library, and I could say give me my result as a list of appointment types. And the Microsoft Extensions AI library is going to actually deserialize into my list of appointment types. So I get that strongly typed collection of appointments, not a block of text that says, oh, well, here's when the appointments are. I can then take
that's
that.
That's what we want.
I can use it in my database. I can use it on my scheduler component. So notice it, there's two sets of messages that are passed in, right? There's that system prompt that kind of sets up, here's how you read the data. And then my user prompt is actually, today is this day, extract appointments from this schedule description, and I pass in the input text.
So I just want to tell everybody that the recurrence thing was the biggest hurdle to get over, because there's a whole language of recurrence that, well, at least the DevExpress scheduler controller uses. But, you know, in your own data shape, you're going to have to convert whatever it gives you into however, you know, whatever your data shape is for recurrence, because it's always going to be different. And I know my customer has, you know, different tables and fields and all that stuff that represent those things. But at least in this case, you're getting something back that you can use and go through and parse to turn in. And you could probably even use AI to take it that next step to say, hey, here's my data shape, right? These are my tables. How would I take the output of this and turn it into real data from my database?
Mm-hmm. Generate that code that's going to do that translation from from the DevExpress model here to your data model, and save off that code that does that translation. Makes perfect sense. But interpreting that prose, right? That person who's on the phone saying, hey, you know what, Carl? Every other week, I need to step away. I've got an appointment with my therapist on Thursdays at 4 p.m. Gosh, how do you turn that into data? How do you load that in? And we can see here, the AI does a fantastic job parsing and turning that into real data for us.
This is so cool and exactly what I was hoping we would get done this week. So, Jeff, thanks for doing the detail work on this. And thank you for watching. And if you have something that you want to contribute, some suggestions or comments or anything like that, send it to Jeff and me by email at codeitwithai@appvnext.com. And we'll check it out. And who knows, maybe we'll use your suggestions in a show. All right. Thanks, Jeff. Thanks for watching, everybody, and we'll see you next time.
Take care, friends.
Thanks for watching. Make sure to check out blazertrain.com and blazerpuzzle.com for more great content.